the Heliway 913 GPS quadcopter. The Heliway 913 quadcopter is a 170mm class brushless quadcopter. You can also find it on the market using many names like Ninja 913, Funky 913, etc., depending on the store that sells it. But Heliway is the sole constructor and distributor. As you can see, it comes with a very nice foam-like case that contains the quadcopter, the transmitter, and some accessories. Inside the case, let's open it. You can find the user manual. It's a very well written user manual. I suggest you read it carefully. The quadcopter. A small Phillips screwdriver. The transmitter, one full set of blades, four to be precise, one USB to micro USB cable, and the battery. The 913 quadcopter, as you can see, it's a very well built aircraft. It has It's a 170 class quadcopter, meaning that the distance between motors is 170mm. On the back of the unit, you can find the micro SD slot. It doesn't come with a micro SD card. You have to provide your own. It supports up to 32 gigabytes of storage. Underneath is the area that the battery slides in and locks. On the front, you can see it has a full HD camera. The angle is manually adjusted, as you can see. Nothing pretty, just you are able to adjust it according to your flying style. The battery, it's a 1500 Li HV LiPo high voltage battery. It's not a smart type, although it has a switch on the back that can be used to turn it off and on and check the storage level. Here we have the micro USB charging port. The battery slides in like this, and you use a small lock here to secure it in place so that it doesn't move while you're flying. The motors are brushless 1306 type with a 3-inch blades, 3-leaf blades. It's a kind of mixed bag between a Spark and a Racer. It doesn't have a gimbal, but it's pretty light and small. It flies very well, however. I really like the way it flies. The transmitter is well built for the price. The usual sticks are here. Here is the on-off switch, the return to home button, the auto take-off button, a function key button that can be used to switch on some auxiliary functions like compass calibration and IMU calibration, the GPS altitude hold mode switch. This quadcopter can fly both in GPS and without GPS in altitude hold, and the spore mode switch, which also switches between spore mode, which can be used both with the GPS and without the GPS. On the top of the transmitter, here we can find the video switch. press it once to start recording, again to stop recording, and the camera snapshot switch. On the bottom here is the charging micro USB slot. The transmitter has a built-in 300 milliamp battery. It can last for 4 to 5 full flight sessions. It's pretty nice. And here is the smartphone clamp that can hold up to 6.44 inch devices like the Xiaomi Mi Max 2 and the quadcopter. By pressing and holding the switch until our LED start to blink, to stop blink, you should not move the aircraft because it will affect the IMU calibration. One thing I'd like to stress out is that you should probably do an IMU calibration to this quadcopter right after you receive it, because there are many reports of users crashing because they simply thought that there was done from the factory. I always do an IMU and compass calibration on every quadcopter or other drone I receive. It's a standard procedure, but I'd like to stress that out, that you should really do it with this one. Don't take it outside, do compass calibrate and try to fly, because you will probably crash. I will show now how to do some operations like the compass calibration and IMU calibration, and a quick tour of the Heliway application. In order to use the application, your smartphone should support the 5.8 GHz Wi-Fi band, the AC as they call it, otherwise you won't be able to connect to the quadcopter access point. When we enable the access point, you can see that it already connected to a Heliway 1080p access point. Let me start the screen capture so that you can see what I'm doing. And after we are connected to the access point, we start the Heliway GPS application. You can find the application both on the Google Play Store and Apple Store. Switch over to 9 1/3 option, and we are connected to the FPV system. The application is pretty simple. From the bottom left towards, we can see we have the return to home button, a small quadcopter icon. Pressing it, it enables you to choose between gesture photography. Gesture photography simply allows you to take a photo. It doesn't work right now. When you do a selfie gesture, enter the VR mode, which can be used if you have one of these VR gaskets that you can put the smartphone inside. It simply projects twice the image, nothing more. The auto takeoff button, the return to previous menu button, the Heliway status bar denotes the flying mode. Right now the quadcopter is in GPS mode, but it cannot get any GPS lock, so it displays its ATI. To switch manually to the attitude hold mode, you simply press the button here. This doesn't do anything. When you are flying in a GPS mode, the bar, it's not yellow as it is now, it's green. It also displayed some messages like return to home distance, and if there are some compass calibration issues and stuff like that. On the top of the screen, you can see the GPS icon up to the right. Now it displays zero satellites. Next to it is the power status indicator for the quadcopter battery. No indication for the transmitter battery. But if the battery on the transmitter is getting low, the power switch blinks and you'll hear an audible beep. On the top right side, there's a gear icon that enters the aircraft status menu. You can switch on the begin and off the beginner mode. The beginner mode places a geofence of 100 meters distance and 30 meters height. That's all it does. The control preference between short mode and sport mode switches between normal mode and sport mode. You can also do the same thing by pressing the sport switch on the transmitter. The self-check usually displays normal. If there is some kind of a problem, you can see some messages here. And beneath there is an IMU and compass calibration button that can be used to calibrate the IMU and the compass respectively. Let me show now the IMU calibration. You can start the calibration either by the app, which I suggest you do, because it will display some messages, or from the transmitter. We'll show that in a moment. Press the calibrate button. You should place the aircraft on a totally level area and do not move it until the compass calibration is finished. It takes about 30 seconds to complete. During that time, the LEDs will flash and you simply wait until the LEDs are solid on. Then the IMU calibration is finished. Only then you can turn and move the aircraft. Otherwise, you have to do it again. Start calibration. As you can see now, the LEDs are blinking. It's calibrating. We'll wait. We will hear some beeps from the aircraft and the motors while doing so. It simply reboots. However, I always power down the aircraft after performing a compass and IMU calibration. It's a habit I have from the old days. Wait some more. Still not done. Do not move the aircraft. Now it's finished. The LEDs are solid on, as you can see. To do the compass calibration, you have to do it outside. We will not do it here, but I will show how it's done. And after the aircraft has acquired some satellites, so that the built-in compass is kind of accurate. To perform the compass calibration, after turning on the function, you simply pick it up, turn it clockwise or counterclockwise, it doesn't matter, horizontally, until the red LED turns off. Then you switch it vertically with the camera pointing downwards and rotate again until the blue LED is on. If you do that using the application, it's much easier because you will get some messages and helpful illustrations while doing so, which I suggest you do. Anyway, if you do not have an application available or your smartphone does not work with the system, you can still do the IMU and the compass calibration simply by, after switching on the transmitter, hold and press the function key until it blinks. Then, to perform the compass calibration, you press the GPS attitude button and you do the dance with the LEDs. No indication, however, because you do not have an app or to the transmitter about the progress. You have to make sure you can see the LEDs clearly. And the IMU calibration can be performed by using the sport button, again by holding the function key switch until the LED blinks, which enters the special calibration mode. Moving up to the application, the next menu here with the camera icon simply has format SD card options, which can be used to format the micro SD card, nothing more. And the three dots simply display the application version and hardware version of the device. Pretty simple. To take a picture, you press either the white switch here on the right side of the application or the camera button here. Same way, if you want to start and stop the video recording, you press the red circle. When you after pressing it, you'll see a countdown, or you can use the button here. And on the bottom right, we have a gallery application icon, which enters the application gallery, where you can see, delete, share, and download the photos and videos from a micro SD card to the device. Forgot to mention that if you do not have a micro SD card inside the aircraft, you can still record video and take pictures, but they will be saved on the smartphone memory, and especially video, expect to get a lot of frame drops due to the Wi-Fi lag. On the bottom, we have a small telemetry strip. On the left is the distance from the transmitter, the height where the aircraft is flying, the horizontal speed and the vertical speed, nothing more. Very simple, very Spartan. If you ask me, it doesn't need anything more. I really like the way it flies. It's a great fun to fly aircraft. The flight duration was about 30 minutes, which is pretty nice for such small battery, and it's the first time I see a Chinese manufacturer with this price range not be overly optimistic about the flight time. It's pretty fast, however. Don't its small size fool you. If you fly in attitude hold mode, you can easily lose it if you don't have a good GPS lock to bring it back. On attitude hold sport mode, the speed it can reach is about 16 meters per second, over 60 kilometers per hour. Pretty fast, if you ask me, for such a small brushless drone. On GPS position hold mode, the normal speed is 3 meters per second, and on sport mode, still using the GPS system, is 5 meters per second. You can still have much fun by flying with GPS. It also supports return to home function, either activated by the user, or if the transmitter loses connection with the aircraft, it will come back. Also, it has a low power protection, where if the battery charge goes beyond 30%, it will start to come back and land slowly. Overall, I really like this quadcopter. It's a fun flyer, easy, it's a complete package. You can get a good value for your money with it and have some fun. The aircraft camera needs some tuning, if I can say that. Somehow it loses sometimes a couple frames, and this leads to a jerky video movement. However, the pictures are pretty nice. A good quadcopter for the money. If you want some park flyer to do some recreational flying. Thank you very much for watching this small demonstration. Please like and subscribe to the channel, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye.